right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to a new episode of It's All Geek to Me. I'm your host, Alan V, and you are tuned in to WSIN Radio 1590 AM, or online at wsinradio.org, or alternately through the TuneIn app. Just download it, type in WSIN, and you're in. So, hi, it's another, actually, I'm not lying this time, it is a legit beautiful Thursday afternoon. Closing out the week here, April 12th, 2018, and I'm back. if you're wondering why I didn't have my normal intro today, that clip is from an actual song called Big Enough, and time permitting, I'm going to close out the show with the song today. It is hilarious, because in the middle of the song, it breaks out to dual screaming cowboys for no coherent reason. The entire song is hilarious, and that screaming part of the song is becoming probably the more hottest growing meme in 2018. But yeah, so last week we talked about, wrestling, specifically WrestleMania, and that was this past Sunday. And don't worry, that's not the topic of our show today. I just figured I'd recap a little. So after all the talk I did about WrestleMania, I figured I should probably mention how it went, whether it was good or not, or what was going on there. It was a pretty good show with some questionably awkward booking, and let me explain that here for you. Booking is how a booker or somebody that does booking, like, you know, how they set up boxing matches, and I would argue boxing's more rigged than wrestling. Another reason I say wrestling is rigged is because the outcome is typically predetermined, though it does change at a moment's notice, especially for Vince McMahon. If you're a person who is trying to convince non-wrestling fans about how legitimate your hobby is, and you have a match where the guy goes out into the crowd and pulls a 10-year-old in as his partner and then wins, that's hard to legitimize to people. Me, I don't care. I fully acknowledge wrestling as the great American male soap opera and love that. I thought it was hilarious because it's not like the kid wrestled. The kid just kind of went in, looked around. The kid was nervous as can be, so you felt bad for him. But a lot of people were up in arms over the booking there, the decision to have this child in the match. And there was a few matches where it was just kind of questionable who they picked to win and why. But overall, I thought it was a pretty good show. The New Day, which ironically enough, they're a tag team trio, so three of them. They come out all sorts of goofy things. If you go to FYE in the mall, you'll see a whole bunch of New Day merchandise, usually the shirt with the unicorn and everything on it. Or alternately, you'll have the New Day cereal and all these other things. So their shtick lately has been pancakes. So when they came out for their match, they had a bunch of, I don't know what term to use without triggering somebody, so let's say little people, i.e. midgets, dressed as stacks of pancakes, doing the worm dancing and other things on the way out to the ring. And my only thought was, if I can wake up and have that be my introduction to breakfast every day, I wouldn't complain. So it was an interesting show. It was definitely entertaining, definitely had its moments and had some very questionably bad moments. If you want to get my full opinion on WrestleMania here, feel free to check out my YouTube channel, which is Chocobo Chokeslam, or my tidbits of commentary on my Twitter, which is at @thelastword2016, because that's when I made that Twitter account. But yeah, so let's go on to what we're going to talk about today. Today's show is going to be a follow-up to one I did in the fall, which I dubbed the Dequickening, and talking about dumb headlines, dumb news, and dumb criminals. And the Dequickening is a reference to the Highlander franchise. You know, the movie with the Scottish guy playing a Spaniard, the French guy playing a Scotsman, and nobody knowing how to act, but still somehow a huge success. That movie. In the Highlander, the whole thing was there can only be one. They were the Highlanders. They were immortals. They found, you know, they're just born immortal. They find out throughout life that they're immortal. They didn't really give a rhyme or reason as to why. But there's this fight where there can only be one, and that's the phrase throughout the franchise. And the first movie is a ongoing feud between Sean Connery's character who, and the guy he's tutoring, who's the French guy playing a Scotsman, instead of, you know, having the Scottish guy with the Scottish accent play the Scotsman. But what do I know about casting in a movie? More than whoever cast in this movie. But, so they fight, and you cut off the other person's head, and when you do that, you inherit their memories and everything else. And the goal, and that's the quickening. When you cut off your opponent's head and you absorb all their memories, i.e. the idea is you become smarter, more complete, and have all their knowledge and tactical strategy, and they call it the quickening. So I went ahead and went with that, talking about when headlines, people, or news is so dumb, that is the dequickening, as you are now getting dumber by the moment. And I did this last semester, and I mentioned something that I'm going to explain a little bit, and I have a little treat for you when we get to these headlines, something called Florida Man. And I did a bit of research, because Florida Man, at least locally here in Connecticut, is a running gag on a couple of radio stations for when they do, like, idiot news or dumbass news or anything like that. Specifically, I know WPLR, they do the daily news, and they have, like, their Loser of the Week, where they take a lot of these stories and they kind of do their, which one was the worst for the week. And they would use Florida Man. And Florida Man, or Florida Woman, is representing this idea, fact, that a lot of these headlines were something incredibly stupid, all start out with a Florida man or a Florida woman. Alternately, you can have area man, because that's another take on it, where everything is area, local area man. Area, A-R-E-A, not Aryan. Although, Florida man typically tends to be Aryan. But I didn't come up with that, so I'm not going to take credit for coming up with the term, and neither did the local, any of the radio guys across the country that use the term Florida man or Florida woman. I did a little bit of research, and then I had some additional people as I was talking about with them that kind of came up with some research. Florida man dates back to The Onion. Those of you now probably know The Onion, hopefully you know The Onion, as a online satirical news network where they do like fake news story, fake newscast. One big one they've done over the years that constantly floats around is a child who's not dying, bankrupting the Make-A-Wish Foundation. And this got passed around as legit news for a while. But no, it was The Onion. It was satire. And one of my headlines is going to be a different organization that does satirical news. But it's going to be one of my honorable mentions, and we'll get to it in a moment here. But for the same reason, it got passed around as a real news story, because a lot of times people can't tell the difference, and that's when you know the organization is doing their satire well. Kind of like during the John McCain election, when people could not figure out or could not correctly recall Tina Fey doing Sarah Palin from actual Sarah Palin, and people insisted actual Sarah Palin said she could see Russia from her house when no, it was an SNL skit. So yeah, along those lines, and some of you are going, oh wait, what do you mean that was an SNL skit? Yeah, no, she didn't actually say that. She said plenty of dumb things, but that wasn't one of them. That was Tina Fey doing a parody of Sarah Palin. But Florida Man, and The Onion is now a website. Years ago, it was an actual satirical newspaper you can order and have delivered monthly, biweekly. I don't know what it was. Again, yes, kids, this was before the internet. The Onion had a movie that came out in the late 80s, I believe. It's hit or miss. I kind of couldn't get into it. Tried watching a little bit of it. But along with the movie, they had like a best of book. And in the opening part of the book is where they explain Florida Man. And it just has to do, as I said before, had these headlines dealing with a Florida resident. They always start out with Florida man or Florida woman, and depending on your take, they either are the world's best or world's worst superhero. So I didn't properly explain that because I went back and listened to that first episode I did. I kind of mentioned it, but didn't really properly explain it. So I figured before we get into this today, I would go over that here with you. Now, these are all different headlines. There are a bunch of criminal ones. There's a couple that are political. They're not, my focus of this show is not to tell you what to think one way or the other politically, rather than just, it's all laughable, and just to think in general. So let's go ahead and get into some of these here. We'll do a few, then we'll take our artist spotlight for the day here, and then we'll come back and do some more. And again, you are listening to It's All Geek to Me. I am Alan V, and you are on WSIN Radio 1590 AM, or online at WSINradio.org. So, our first headline, and this is the one, this is my honorable mention because it turned out to not be true, I guess is a good thing, but I was hoping for how stupid it was that it was true. And I have another one on here that I'm going to read that is true, but it sounds too stupid to be true. But my first one, this headline read, "Man hospitalized for having sex with clam." And again, this one was published on World News Daily, which is a satirical news site. The headline was hilarious, and the article chronicles it's a fictional story about a Hawaiian native who was sent to the hospital after he tried to free willy inside of a large clam while scuba diving off the coast of wherever in Hawaii, since Hawaii's an island, there's always off the coast. That alone was my inspiration for wanting to do another Dequickening episode, because and unfortunately it's not real, so I'm a little disappointed, but I think for the sake of humanity, this is a good thing that it's not real. But wow, and it's something I would expect people to actually try to do. So my first thought is if you're trying to have sex with a clam, is that the same as being clam jammed? I'm not going to go into what the alternative is, because I'm not sure if I'm allowed to use the word on air, but it's the female equivalent of a guy who's trying to make work his magic with a woman getting blocked. You just really, the headline alone makes the story. Man hospitalized for trying to have sex with a giant clam. Now, I know clam is a euphemism for the female organ, but really, and I'm glad this is fake, because it's just, thank God we're not this stupid. But I don't have this in order the way I'm going to go with this, but I'm going to go ahead and jump to that one. On the level of stupid, in this headline I came across and verified that it is true, sadly, all these are verified, either fake or real. I found them either on a real news organization or went on Snopes and some other fact check places to make sure if they were from a satirical site or something along those lines. But this one here, the headline is 16.4 million American adults believe chocolate milk comes from brown cows. Yes, this is a real headline from a real news source. This was published on April 8th on the Washington Post. That 7% of American adults, or 16.4 million of them, that are way too stupid to be allowed to reproduce, believe chocolate milk comes from brown cows. Let me help y'all out here and explain where chocolate milk comes from. And a key hint, it's in the name of the product.
Chocolate!
Yeah. Chocolate! Now, God only knows where these people think chocolate comes from. And one of the dumb things, and PETA's notorious for this, because this has been passed around over the years, they argue that chocolate milk is milk that's filled with pus from brutal practices, and they mix it together and it gets the brown coloring, and that's why it's chocolate milk. No, that is beyond any conceivable level of retarded. No, PETA, that's not where chocolate milk comes from, because we actually sell the syrup to make chocolate milk at home. And no, as much as I don't trust the FDA, they're not going to allow people to sell pus-filled milk. It is going to taste nasty. It is going to make people sick. Even with the pasteurization process, we are not selling pus-filled milk. Now, there are people that want to drink unpasteurized milk, and if you want to play Russian roulette with your insides, be my guest. No, chocolate milk comes from chocolate, people. And chocolate comes from it's from a plant, the cacao or cocoa plant. It's not from brown cows. How dumb are you? Do you think, black people make black chocolate milk? What level of stupid are you reaching for here? If all humans make the whitest colored breast milk, Why would you assume animals make different colored milk? Even the echidna and the platypus, which don't have nipples, they have patches that lactate, which is gross. They're monotremes. They're awesome animals because they're a giant FU to trying to figure out evolution. They make milk, and it's not chocolate. So I want to know where you people think strawberry milk comes from. Do you think we go and milk strawberry plants? Now, granted, I can understand some confusion because we have almond milk and coconut milk and all these other things that aren't milk that we call milk. And I understand, like, I'm not on the vegan thing, but you, as you get older, you become a little more lactose intolerant. And I'll go on to side note of how, you know, I found that out the hard way about a month ago when I made chicken enchiladas for my D&D party and put about a block and a half of cream cheese and an entire bag of shredded cheese. And it was delicious, but I was dying the next morning and all day. So I understand wanting less of lactose, which is a byproduct or ingredient in the milk we get from cows, goats, and yes, we drink from other animals than cows too. You can get sensitive or allergic to it as you get older, because technically all other animals drink their own species' milk, and I kind of don't like the idea of running around drinking other people's boob juice, okay? Let's not, you know, PETA's use that as an anti-dairy thing where they, what if we hooked women up to these things? And I'm like, well, not for nothing, PETA's. For some people, that's a fetish, but no, I'm okay with drinking cow or goat milk or sheep milk, depending where you are. And the French part of me is very big when it comes to cheese. I like that the creamier and the stinkier it is, the better the cheese is to me. So I like some of the weird stuff with that, but no, not for a second. Okay. French cheese doesn't come from French cows. I mean, technically it does because they're cows in France, but it's a process in how they make the cheese. It's not the animal. All cows have regular milk. I just don't understand how 16.4 million of you could be this stupid. I don't want this to be the real story, because I can conceivably believe one moron would try to have sex with a clam, because that's going to tie into my next headline. But how in God's name do you not understand that the fur pattern doesn't dictate the color of the milk? But anyway, speaking of some moron having sex with a clam, and this is also one that was, I found it on Facebook and had to check the headline just to make sure, and it is real. This headline is, Louisiana law to ban sex with animals wins Senate vote 25-10. Now, my first thought, who were the 10? Now, my response to the thread this was shared on was, it was possibly 10 people who figured this was a waste of legislation. Which is kind of how I look at it. Like, we shouldn't have to waste legislative power to say you don't have sex with animals. But I wouldn't vote against this. What 10 psychopaths in Louisiana said, nope, it should be okay to have sex with your goat? That should say passes Senate vote 35-0. Or 25 with 10 abstaining. Not no. So, first thought is, who said no? Second thought is, what the heck happened that this hadn't come before the Senate of Louisiana for legislation? I want to know the other story of what you came across, what you found, what a horrific thing happened that led to this legislation being proposed in 2018. Because I would expect this is the 100-year anniversary of banning sex with animals. No, this just got passed in 2018. So what the heck happened? Legit. I want to know. I want to know, but I don't want to know. Who did what to trigger this becoming part of the actual legislative process? And as a friend of mine coined, did this suddenly lead, or is it going to lead to the Moo Too movement? I am not belittling the Me Too movement, but can we just stop having sex with things that aren't consenting in society? Like, just stop. It's not that hard. Moo doesn't mean yes. And I go to somebody, neither does it mean no. Moo means moo. Usually if my guinea pig's screaming at me, it's because she wants food. And I'm not going to go where my brain just went. Never mind. Okay, fine, I will. Never mind the logistics. But usually an animal is wanting food or for you to leave it alone, or if it's a pet, to be pet. There's no animal consenting. Just, people, stop trying to sleep with things that can't consent. That'll end a lot of problems in the world. Okay, so we had the guy having sex with clams. We had the 16.4 million morons who should all be sterilized, not understanding where chocolate milk comes from. We have the Louisiana Senate making me question what the hell is going on in their state. And I have a couple more here because I kind of jumbled some of these around. I want to talk about this one. It's a pair of headlines because this just... In England right now, or the UK in particular, because I think this guy was from Scotland, they arrested a YouTuber and convicted him of a hate crime. And again, I'm not defending what he did. It was in poor taste, but it was a joke, not a crime. He taught his girlfriend's pug to essentially give paw to Nazi propaganda, which, okay, to me is hilarious. And I've seen the video. It's hilarious because he would go Sieg Heil and the dog would put its paw up. And then he would say some other, like, you know, I'm not saying this line because someday in my life that this line out of context is going to be blasted somewhere to ruin my career. But he would say other Nazi propaganda to get the dog to give paw. And it was on YouTube. The girlfriend was mortified, but not like, oh my goodness, it's the end of the world. But somehow this got turned into a hate crime. And again, I have from the article here, in 2016, the guy's name is Mark Meechan, posted a video showing him to teach his girlfriend's pug to raise his paw upon hearing Sieg Heil and another phrase, and the video was viewed more than a million times. He was then charged with a hate crime because England is psychotic. Like, I'm not even defending England. I like Doctor Who. I love your dry humor and your comedy in general. But your government makes ours look sane. And it's just something in the world right now, rabbit trail here, about all the former Anglo-Saxon colonies, us, Canada, Australia, and England, where we're all nuts. We're all overly offended, hyperized victimization. We're just, like, is there a self-destruct sequence in Anglo-Saxon DNA? Like, I don't know. But, so the dog, here we go. Let's get back into that. So what we had here is Meechan, when he was arrested and then going through court, he defended his behavior, saying it was a way to prank his girlfriend, and said that after he was arrested that he doesn't actually hate Jewish people. No crap. And my thing is, the British courts actually, the United Kingdom courts, actually wasted time, taxpayer money, and taxpayer resources to convict a dude for basically teaching a dog to give paw. And my response to this is, can I dump a pallet of tea into the Boston Harbor just as a symbolic middle finger to the British government right now? Because you're a joke. All right, I'm not defending his actions. Like, I'm not defending... What he did was in poor taste, but it was done as a joke. Intent matters. You don't just get a... Like, and it's awesomely... Like, I love some of the kids, because I'm older than most of them, but some of my fellow classmates, we can have honest discussions about things, and, like, understandably, certain words are offensive to certain people. And I get why, but with any situation, context and intent matter. Was the word or phrase or thing in question part of a statement or something they were reading? Was it meant to be a joke? What was it? The idiot from Seinfeld when he went out and when people realized he wasn't funny at doing stand-up and as for shock humor, he used the N-word. He was an idiot. And it happened the way I believe it should happen, where is the market kind of just wrote him off. People were like, I'm not going to pay to go see him. I'm done with him. I'm not defending his actions, but do I think he's this horrible racist or does he committed a crime? No, but he's an idiot. I want to say Richard Dreyfuss. But yeah, it's this guy in England. It was stupid, but it was funny to him, to millions of people watching it, but not to the British government. And I'm going to follow this up with, because I couldn't find the exact headline I wanted, but at the same time these courts in this in England are, and the UK are wasting time convicting this dude for doing something stupid that shouldn't be a crime, London police, and this is another headline, London police investigated over claims it protected a pedophile ring. I only included this because of the last one I just talked about. So we're too busy trying to stop the rise of Nazi pugs to, I don't know, deal with actual crime. And there was another headline floating around on Twitter involving a pedophile ring where it was a London sheriff, chief, whatever their constable, whatever their equivalent is over there, where they're asked why didn't pursue a particular pedophile ring, and this might be the same related headline, was it was too much work. Like, I guess they didn't have enough direct info to easily pursue it. I'm sorry, do your job. Like, not dog giving paw to a bad word. Child being ruined for the rest of their life. I'm kind of seeing not an equal or even remotely equal aspect here. But so, and I have, before I go to my artist spotlight and get into our other headlines here, I have one more I want to go over. And this one's touchy. I apologize ahead of time. I found it amusing just because of the whole, you know, political background. This one's out of Florida, but it's not Florida, man. This one was from, I believe, the Miami Herald, and it's Parkland students upset over clear backpack policy. According to the Miami Herald, students are upset over having their right to privacy taken away by the implementation of backpacks, clear backpacks. Gee, it's almost like people don't like having their rights taken away. Funny when the shoe's on the other foot, kids, huh? And secondly, so that's my first reason why. The headline itself's not stupid. And I'm not telling you where to stand on this argument. I'm just saying do research because most of the propaganda being spread on each side is kind of not correct. I don't personally believe in just arming teachers is a solution, but there are those who take classes and get certifications that I'm not against. And obviously, outright bans, we've tried in facts, data, and the fact that we now have a higher murder rate in London than we do in New York City. Evidence shows that trying to ban everything doesn't work either. We did this in the 90s, and we still had Columbine and a bunch of other incidents. I want both sides to just kind of chill out with just being morons, and let's maybe try to figure out a real solution. But I got a problem with everything, and why I found this kind of amusing, and again, I'm sorry, being a little political, my stance is I'm more libertarian or more center-leaning than I don't like the left, the far left or the far right. I just find both dichotomous extremes to be horribly incorrect. But I can be respectful because there's no reason people can't be on opposite political spectrums and still be friends and communicate with each other. That idiotic nonsense of if you don't believe what I do, I can't be friends with you is childish and stupid. Now, there are times where things can happen, like if you're really close friends with a trans person and you have another friend who's just like to the point where they don't believe in it and are bigoted about it and hostile towards the other person, that's different. I mean, there are obviously there's no black and white in this. There are gray areas. So, you know, take what I'm saying with the context of how I'm saying it. You know, the thing I said a minute ago. But I find it stupid that CNN took this poor David Hogg kid and made him the poster child. The NRA found their kid and made him a poster child. Meanwhile, I'm over here going, can we stop exploiting these children? What happened was horrible. But the whole time you had all this stuff about banning whatever weapon, and I'm not getting into that discussion because most of what people that want to ban assault weapons, A, don't know what one is, don't know the caliber of the ammo and how it works, and just are spouting the same misinformation over and over again. Meanwhile, those on the far right are now suddenly interested in psychology when they dismiss it as a valid field of science every other day. So I'm just kind of fed up on both. So I'm not getting into that discussion. I certainly can have an episode, if there's interest, talking about gun control and gun rights and giving my take on it, but I'm just not, that's not the point today. The point is dumb headlines. The other reason why I wanted to go on why this is a dumb headline is, what moron or batch of morons thinks see-through backpacks are going to stop a shooter? Oh, I'm going to stop. You see it in my backpack as I'm coming in the door. That's not how that works. Now, okay, some kids have brought them into the school, put them in their lockers and stuff. But typically, they just come in guns akimbo, unfortunately. Saying this is going to stop shootings is as stupid as saying, as, I don't know, a sticker on the door or a sign that says gun-free zone. Oh, wait. That's right. We do think stupidly here in America. So, yeah, I my little bit of politics on this one, I'm not going to dwell on it. I found the irony of these kids who have been campaigning about taking other people's toys away and other people's rights away. And again, there's those that are, well, we're not about taking them away. Well, your party immediately proposed a bill banning all semi-automatic rifles, which, since nobody knows what the terminology means, that is literally every rifle on the market. So, yeah, it is about taking them away. So I'm just going to cut all the crap out there. Maybe not with these kids, but that's what the party that's using them is about. And likewise, the NRA and Republicans are doing their own thing with their poster child, and it's just as gross. But the irony was too delicious to not mention that after all the campaigning, parading, and screaming about how dumb everyone else is because they're not willing to surrender their rights, well, shoes on the other foot. You don't like it now, do you? So, yeah, that was the one political one. And again, I apologize to anybody that's offended, but, you know, you're all adults. You can deal with it. But we're going to take our artist spotlight here, and I'm going to come back and we'll do some more headlines through the rest of the show. Our artist of the day are called The Rallies, and their album is called Serve. It's basic pop rock from the description on here, and the track we're going to play is called Don't Give Up. And we are at 4:30 in the afternoon here on a beautiful Thursday, April 12th. This is It's All Geek to Me. I am Alan V. This is WSIN Radio 1590 AM. And we'll go ahead and take a music break, and I'll be right back with you.
Don't give up on love. Don't give up on love. Don't give up. When you think there's nothing left and you're feeling like you've had enough, don't give up. When something's got to give and you've got the edge of letting go, don't let go. When your love is on the run and you're feeling like you've come undone, don't give up. When nothing's going right and you're looking for a guiding light, don't give up. Don't give up. Oh,
All right, ladies and gentlemen, that was Don't Give Up by The Rallies. So now we're going to get into the second half of our show here today, where we're going to do Dumb Criminals. So going away from just, there's a couple more just regular dumb headlines in here, but we're going to be going mostly into Dumb Criminals. And with that, we're going to get into Florida Man. Florida Man! Faster than a speeding El Camino, more powerful than a Dodge Hemi, able to leap an exploding meth lab in a single bound, it's Florida Man! No crime too stupid, no decision too dumb. Okay. I got that right on the first take. Awesome. All right. So, yeah, we're going to be getting into Florida Man territory. But let's go over a couple here since I got that page out of the way. We got a few from around the country just so it doesn't look like I'm bashing on Florida in particular. It's just, it is way too easy because there are so many great dumb headlines. But the first one I have is jail job applicant not hired, arrested instead in theft case. Associated Press report that a woman who applied for a job at a local county jail in New Hampshire was instead arrested for an outstanding warrant in Maine. You know, when you tell your kids they're special, sometimes you need to clarify to them what kind of special you mean. Oh, wow. Police say Christina Hoyfs, and I'm saying the names because they're convicted, of Manchester, New Hampshire, applied for a job on Friday at the Hillsborough County Police Department of or County Department of Corrections, but workers soon realized she was being sought on a theft-related offense in Maine. This sounds like she should have applied for a political position instead. And again, you knew you stole something. You had to know you were wanted, thus you're not living in Maine anymore. Why would you apply at a corrections facility or anything in the legal field? Like, come on! It's like being a crack dealer and applying to be a part, you know. Oh, I was gonna make a drug dealer being a pharmacist, but with the opioid epidemic, they're one and the same right now. Pharmaceuticals and drug dealers. Except one is killing people far more than the other, and it's not the street vendor drug dealer. But yeah, come on. You don't have a criminal background and apply to work in a police station or police department. Just, what's the old Carlos Mencia song? How many idiots can there be? Some say there's one out of three. Well, we found one. And this one's more of just, not a dumb criminal, but just a headline of, it's meant to be one of these cute headlines, but this is incredibly stupid. Police, fed up with lingering cold weather, arrest winter. And this is another Associated Press article from Depew, New York. I don't have much here. The headline alone is just stupid. Way to waste taxpayer time, money, and resources. All I'm going to say, though, is just be glad that none of these officers fared for their lives. Otherwise, winter would be dead. I don't know, wait. I wouldn't be too worried. I kind of like that idea. But again, I get it's supposed to be cute. Like, a lot of times they symbolically arrest a groundhog or do these other dumb feel-good things in the community. But do you understand what a waste of time and resources that is? I mean, it's bad enough we still do Groundhog Day in this country. An awesome movie with Bill Murray. I recommend everybody to watch that. If you're a film major, you will be watching that. It is used in every film curriculum across the country in college. I had to watch that when I was in community college getting my associates, and if I had to do those classes here, I'd be watching them too. But it's a great movie, both as a movie and from a philosophy standpoint. But just, I don't get why we would do these stupid things like this. Like, okay, if you want to do something good for the community, like local police officers help feed the homeless, local police officers help, you know, replace little kid's stolen bicycle. Those are relevant feel-good stories that bridge the tension between the local police and the community. Fake arresting something doesn't do anything, and other than waste time. How about you go arrest the war on drugs next? You know, that's worked out wonders for us. Okay, and I did the two in London. So here's another one. Two men try to rob a pub in Maryland without realizing it's hosting a cop's retirement party. Yes. Oh, this is delicious. And around 5:30 p.m. last Tuesday night, police say Joseph McInnes III, who's 21, and Tyree McCoy, 22, attempted to stage an armed robbery at a pub in Woodlawn, Maryland. There was just one problem. The bar was hosting a retirement party for a police officer and was filled to the brim with off-duty cops. Wow. That is, like, Super Saiyan levels of stupid. Did you not walk in, look around before, you know, I'm assuming pulling out guns or however you're robbing it and robbing the place? That was tantamount to the level of stupid as walking into a gun store and trying to rob the place. You're going to get shot. You're 21 and 22. Come on. I expect, like, 15-year-olds to be this stupid. I'm not saying that they're stupid because they're 15. It's just the type of thing you associate with, like, being younger, not being aware of your surroundings. But, nope, these two went full retard here and decided to just rob a place filled with cops. So, obviously, that didn't end the way they wanted it to. I'm not even done yet with the dumb bank the robbery ones. They're getting closer to Florida. This one's in Georgia. Bank robbery suspect arrested after stopping for news interview during crime spree. Oh, wow. I can't. Wow. A bank robbery suspect in Gwinnett County, Georgia, is accused of making a crucial mistake following his alleged crime. He let his identity be known. Eric Rivers was arrested Tuesday in connection with a spree of bank robberies in Lawrenceville, Georgia, after he appeared in an on-camera interview with local news station for an unrelated story about public transit. Good job, moron. Good job. That'll do, pig. That'll do. All right, here we go. Now we're getting into Florida, man. Man, that's just awesome. Florida man shoots out tires of AT&T truck he claims was blocking his driveway. I'll read that again. A Florida man shoots out the tires of an AT&T truck that he claims was blocking his driveway. See, editor, I actually corrected your grammar here and read that properly. Now, a disgruntled Florida senior... Dad? I swear to God, Dad, when you go down to Florida, if this turns out to be you one day, we're going to have a talk. A disgruntled Florida senior found a rather forceful, not to mention dangerous, way of expressing his frustration with an AT&T employee's parking job. Video captured by an AT&T employee shows 64-year-old man in Haleah, Florida, using a large revolver to shoot out the tires of a parked repair truck while the employees looked on incredulously. See, when I worked in IT with a local internet service provider, which I'm not going to say the name of, well, just because I'm not giving them any free publicity, we had to do, and this actually was used as justification for closing the center we worked at, and out, you know, because they sold the company. We had to do safety reports once a month, like looking around the office or outside in the parking lot of something like stupid that needed to be fixed. I was always smart with it because I just thought it was a waste of time and kind of picked up on, hey, they're selling the company. We're like the redhead stepchild because we're, you know, A, performing better than their central territory, but they don't want us. I always put something stupid like big ass spider by the front entrance or crack in sidewalk. I used to look at some of the field techs and the stuff they would put. One of them was a giant garter snake on a junction box with not touching the nope rope as their caption, which was awesome. I would love to read the report that was submitted for this by the AT&T employee. Because I dealt with some crazy senile people on the phone and not senile people. But don't worry, someday here I will, before I graduate, I will do a Tales from the Call Center episode. It's just something precious to me, so I want to spend time putting it together. And I want to read, like, just crazy old dude shooting tires. I'm taking the rest of the day off. Like, something insane as, like, that the headline to that. But imagine being the person at AT&T that has to field the calls from the field techs of, like, when there's problems, and you're getting a call, and it's like, hi, yeah, a guy is shooting at us. And you get back, like, are you being shot at? No, just the vehicle. We're cool. He blew up our tires because he's mad that we're parked in his driveway. Yeah, we know it's stupid and counterproductive, and now we can't move the truck. But you send the police? Like, I just to be a fly on the wall in that conversation. Oh, yeah. There we go, more Florida, as we're going to close out the show here with nothing but Florida. Cross-dressing bandits arrested after Florida Home Depot robbed. Why the cross-dressing? Like, if that's your thing, cool, you know, I'm not judging. But were you trying to be, like, the wet bandits from Home Alone where you have a shtick or a gimmick? But police in Polk County, Florida, say they arrested three suspects in a series of robberies that were as violent as they were unusual. I'm pretty sure the unusual is bigger here. On July 6th, this one's a little bit older, three young men walked into a Home Depot in Winter Haven in drag, including, writer, including wigs, dresses, and open-toed shoes. That's evident in the word drag. Police say they attempted to steal gift cards through the store's self-checkout, resulting in a physical confrontation with a store clerk. Like, that's a I'm going home day. And I've had those days. I mentioned previously about the day I got held at gunpoint when I worked at CVS. That was a go-home day. This, for me, if I were the guy that had to deal with this, would be, you're paying me to go home. You're not even going to argue this with me. I'm done. Like, okay, you go to apprehend a dude in drag, and you accidentally grab his pectorals. Is that now sexual harassment? How does that work? Oh, boy, that just... Florida man. Okay, here's another one. It's a windy day. Florida woman, 26, tells police cocaine they found in her bag must have flown in through the car window. Oh, boy. A Florida woman, age 26, tried to get out of being found with cocaine in her purse by telling police she had no idea where it came from and that it must have blown in through the window. Now, okay, I've seen plenty of videos where the police plant drugs on a person. But, lady, this is a reach. Usually they plant it in the car. Supposedly, if they do it. But, come on. I would just say I stole this purse. It's not mine. Like, just make up some other dumb thing. You're already getting arrested. I don't know where the cocaine came from, officer. It must have flew in through the window with, delivered by the magical bag-carrying cocaine fairy. Seriously. Oh, boy. Okay, next one I have here. Man found his door broken in with a cinder block and a burglar in his shower, Florida cops say. Wow. And I didn't write the info on that one, but yeah, it was. I remember this one because this was one I added last night. Guy got home from work, basically found that his door was open, goes in the house, and finds the criminal that broke in taking a shower. Do they not have a YMCA down in Florida? Because, like, I can't tell if it was a homeless dude that wanted to get cleaned up, a drug addict that wanted to get cleaned up before a job interview, or just a dude that wanted to get out of the heat or the cold. Yeah, it would be cold, because this is a recent headline. But how awkward is that? Coming home to find a dude that broke in your home to take a shower. This is like Goldilocks and the Three Bears. Actually, in this case, it'd be Goldschlager and along with Three Bears. Because there's no way this was done sober. I can only imagine this had to be a dude that was just completely plastered, couldn't figure out how to get home, and just said, I live here now, broke the door open, and went to take a shower to sober up. That's Florida. And even more Florida. Florida man, rather. Man threw homemade bomb at chickens in Fort Pierce. Wow. And here we go. A man in Fort Pierce is accused of making a homemade bomb and hurling it at a yard full of chickens. What, he was trying to make Kung Pao chicken? What do they have? Dynamite chicken is another one you can get at the Chinese restaurants? Oh, maybe he wanted to go visit Bangkok. Oh, man. How much alcohol was involved here? All right. So, hurling a yard full of chickens, the St. Lucie County Sheriff's Office arrested 55-year-old Scott Wagner. A witness told police Wagner built an IED from a Canadian mist bottle. And that Canadian mist is a like a Sprite type of soda. Filled with black powder, sand, and a green fuse. Yeah, I just read how to make a bomb. I'm sorry. Great job on the article here, guys. Just published that. Not that people need to know how. I learned how to make napalm when I was like in sixth grade by looking stuff up on the internet. Just for liability purposes. I am not going to announce that on air. But he ignited and threw it in a backyard where witnesses had some chickens, saying he wanted to kill them, according to the report. Yeah, he wanted to make dynamite chicken or firecracker chicken or Kung Pao chicken. He was hungry. Why do I feel like this is a new KFC ad? KFC's Mega Bucket. It's an explosion of chicken. Holy cow. Again, Pabst Blue Ribbon had to be involved in that scenario. What's the thing from South Park? Look at the camera and say it. No, I'm not going to. We'll add on to your charges. Fine. This is Pabst Blue Ribbon, and I'm white trash, and I'm in trouble. And my final main headline, and since we have a couple minutes to go, I actually have the site pulled up. We'll check if there's anything new on there. Florida man tries to rob 7-Eleven by pointing his finger like a gun at the clerk. I'll read that again without laughing this time. Florida man tries to rob 7-Eleven by pointing his finger like a gun at the clerk. I know it's a job at 7-Eleven. You don't give a crap at that point. You're just there for money. What little you're going to get. It's not anything you're going to risk your life for. Like, heck, the day I got robbed at CVS, it was 8 in the morning. We barely were open. We opened at 7, so I had at most $80 in my drawer. I'm worth more than $80, so here, take it. Leave. But this is a level of just, I don't care about my job, that's sad. Authorities are looking for help identifying a man they say pointed a finger at a 7-Eleven clerk and demanded cash early Wednesday before... Okay, at least he left empty-handed. It happened around 2 a.m. at the store over on Bonita Beach Road near Imperial Shores Boulevard. So at least the clerk said no, because I would... If the clerk was like, don't shoot, and handed the money, I'd be a little biffed. But, yeah, that's a special level of stupid when you come in with your finger and try to stick up a place. Man, so yeah, we've had some great headlines. All right, and I'm going to pull that up for the close out the show here. So let's go on the website really quick and we'll find a couple more. All right, here's a couple headlines. This website, if you want to check it out, it's amazing. I didn't find all of these on here. I did a lot of searching around, then came across this site. But it's just floridaman.com. And here's one. Florida man shoots himself in the leg to profess love for ex-girlfriend. There's no point in time where I'm going to shoot myself intentionally over a partner. But here we go. A South Florida man's plan to win back the love and affection of his ex-girlfriend included shooting himself in the leg. Honey, I think you're doing better than your exes. Yvonne, can't pronounce that last name, Filguera, 26, and his girlfriend broke up in January after he cheated on her with another woman. Okay, so you're a double loser. She broke up with you because you cheated on her. So, which means the woman you were cheating with figured out you're a loser and dropped you. And then you go and shoot yourself in the leg. Like, how does that discussion happen? Babe, I love you. Watch. Bang. Holy cow. So Figueroa called the woman at her homestead home on March 11th, saying he was going to shoot himself in the thigh to prove he loves her, adding he knew he could hit an artery and he may bleed out. Okay, so this YDI, I can't feel bad for him. After his comment, so you tell her you're going to do this so she doesn't come back to you, and then you did it before she even had a chance to respond. After his comment, the ex said she heard a gunshot and Figueroa was screaming that he needed a paramedic. All right, because I'm a decent human being, I would call the paramedic, but it's almost one of those moments where you just stay on the phone and go, like, no, because if I call the paramedic, you're not going to learn your lesson. But, oh, wow. And I got one more here. Florida man tells cops his name is Captain Dickhead. And the other kid, when you go and click on the article, Florida police report, arrest of Captain Dickhead. A Florida man was arrested early yesterday after telling police that his name was Captain Dickhead. Cops responding at 1:45 a.m. to a disturbance at a residence in Sebastian encountered Pamela Alange, who apologized for arguing loudly with her boyfriend in the home's backyard. So yes, alcohol was definitely involved. When asked multiple times to identify himself, the boyfriend refused and was being evasive and argumentative with officers at the scene. According to an arrest affidavit, after cops handcuffed the man, they took one more shot at extracting a name from him, at which time he said his name was Captain Dickhead. Oh, wow. Why? You know now for the rest of your life, you idiot, you're going to have an alias anytime you get pulled over. So, again, investigators subsequently identified Dickhead as Joseph Boren, age 25. He was arrested on a misdemeanor obstruction charge. So for the rest of his life, when he gets pulled over, because, again, this is not going to be an isolated incident, usually never is, it's going to be, so is your name Joseph Captain Dickhead Boren? That's now going to be with you for the rest of your life, dude. That is priceless. I love it. So, yeah, we're winding down the hour here, and I want a special treat. That song I played in the intro to start the show with the Screaming Cowboy, I'm going to end the show playing the entire song because it's hilarious. But I want to thank everybody for tuning in today. I hope you had as much fun as I did. So this has been a great, just really fun afternoon here, and I want to thank you again for tuning into It's All Geek to Me. Again, my name is Alan V. I am on every Thursday during the school year from 4 to 5. So I'll be running through May at least and then back in the fall. But it's been a pleasure. I want to thank you all for joining me today. Peace out. Enjoy the rest of your weekend. God bless. And just remember, don't be Captain Dickhead. Take care, everybody. Take it easy.
Cities. I've crossed deserts on camelback, and I filled the halls of folklore with things I'd rather we forget. I could sweep you off the streets, so seeing this is goddamn tough, but this town might be big enough. See, I reckon what you're saying, but this does run every course. I roamed without my boots on, I raced without my horse, and then I ate my horse's meat straight from my horse's bones. 'Cause this dog must rhyme a line. Rain. We could do it in- side as we walk the plain. It wouldn't give us any closure. All cowboys need to trust that this town might be big enough for both of us. Said this in a lonely town, and what I wouldn't give to have a friend around. We could trade in all our silver bullets and buy a patch of dust. This town might just be big enough. Yeah.